you know, that gentleman mentioned what is the ingredient of the best TED Talk. One of the top lists was the color of the shirt. And if you notice that my kurta is almost matching that. So you are likely to have the best TED Talk in the session today. I'm going to share my story, you know, how I ended up in the business of providing solar lamp to the students in the rural areas. This is the school that I come from. So I come from a village. So I come from Madhya Pradesh, and within Madhya Pradesh, there's a district called Khargon. Within district Khargon, there is a tehsil called Jirnya. Within Jirnya tehsil, there is a post called Igria. And within Igria post, there's a village called Nemeth. So I come from this school, and when I used to study there, the school used to have one classroom. And in one classroom, there are five classes sitting, you know, half row for the first, and another half row the second, and third, and fourth. Many years have gone, or many years, 35 years have gone, and now this school has two classrooms, you know, the five classes and of two teachers. Well, and this is a fact for many, many schools all over the country. Well, but I was fortunate enough to, you know, my father sent me to the urban areas, and then I could get admission in IIT, and I could actually went abroad to pursue PhD in solar energy. And this is a long distance. I'm going from the Nemeth village to a Belgium in the Inter-University Microelectronics Center, which is one of the best research center in the microelectronics and nanoelectronics and photovoltaics. Meanwhile, there are many things happened. So when I was about to complete my engineering, I wanted to get into the doing entrepreneurship and business, and I wanted to make and have a factory of making plastic shoes and chappal, because I found it very, you know, kind of innovative, in the sense that the whole material can get recycled within the village. You know, the kulfi wallas go around and then sell, they give the kulfi and actually get in return the plastic materials. But I was really young, and that time the loan was required about some 1.5 to 2 lakh rupees, and my father was really against it to actually even to dare to have such loan, you know, coming from the farming facility. Anyway, I ended up in IIT Bombay, worked with various NGOs, and I was actually a graduate of microelectronics, and I was working in Texas Instruments, a very highly paid job in 99. Then I started thinking to actually do something in the area, in the technology, which can actually be useful for society. And that is how I landed up in the IMEC, in the Microelectronics Center, and did my research in photovoltaics. Well, but I remember that while I was studying there, I was using kerosene lamp. And there are many kind of things that are associated with the kerosene lamp that you have to be careful about, that you don't get burned, you know. Then there are a lot of things lying around. There's indoor pollution. And if you look at the numbers and statistics, and there are many burns which actually happens because of the kerosene lamp. If you look at the indoor pollution, there are about 3.4 million deaths happens all around the world because of the indoor pollution. That there are many reasons, and kerosene is one of the reasons. So what can we do? What can we do, and can with this advancement of technology, when the India is actually having a national solar mission and the solar technology is so successful all over the world, can we not replace every kerosene lamp with the solar lamp? And if you look at the data, census data 2011, when the main source of lighting is given, and if you look at the data of how the kerosene is used as the main source of lighting, so there's a major portion in India, the middle part, where the household which are using kerosene is actually more than 20%. The red one is more than 40%. The purple one is more than 60%. So you'd think that in such an advancement of technology, when we are talking about really advanced world, you know, we are flying and sending satellites and etc., we would actually be having the technology that can replace the kerosene lamp with the solar lamp. But at the same time, if you look at the solar lamp as a main source of lighting, the penetration all over the country is this purple color, which is less than 1% household that is using the solar lamp as a main source of lighting. Another important thing is what can we use this solar lamp? Of course, solar energy can be used for many purposes, and we need many, many purposes. But because India is a very young country, you know, there are about 300 million students, or 300 million population, which is aged between 0 to 14 years. So one basic question we should ask ourselves, and how many units of electricity is required if you want to make a child study 4 hours every day in a 365 days? Any guess? Let me give the hint that, you know, whatever answer you are going to give, there's a chance that 99% it will be wrong answer, because I already tried this question on many forums. How many units of electricity is required if you want to ensure that child studies 4 hours every day, 365 days in a year? You'll be surprised to know that just 0.7 unit of electricity. That is just enough electricity that we need to provide. And if you, those who not do not know the sense of 0.7 unit of electricity, if you're using a geyser in your house, you turn it on for 20 minutes, you'll be consuming this much amount of electricity. Only in that much electricity you can ensure that a child studies throughout the year, 4 hours every day. Another thing, as I mentioned, is we have to ensure that, you have to remember that India is a very young country. There are 300 million people below age 14, and there are 800 million people between 0 to 35 years of age. There are 289 million students in the schools of India in 2013-14. Out of that, 189 million students in rural schools. So you can imagine with this kind of statistics, and again, referring to the census 2011, there are 78 million households who are using kerosene for the as the main source of lighting. There's another important thing you have to notice is not only we should provide a solar lamp when there is no light, we should also provide a solar lamp for study when there is an intermittent light supply. But what we are surprised to know, to found that you need to provide a solar lamp even if there's a 24-hour electricity. So we have done a sampling of almost about 2,300 households in six districts, including Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, and Odisha, to find out how much is the light level at the floor which is required for study purpose. If you look at the amount of light that is required for study is about 150 lux of light, and that is a lux as a unit of measurement of the intensity of light, and it is an international standard that is proposed to have enough light. But if you look at the amount of light that is there on the floor in the villages, is somewhere between 5 to 20 lux. So even if there is a 24-hour light there, it is not sufficient for study purpose, because the walls are not plastered, there is no whitewash, there is mud walls, and there is thatched wall, and all kind of things are there. So we need to provide them solar lamp for situation when there is no light, for the situation when there is a partial light, and for the situation when there is a full 24-hour light available, because we are not giving them enough the light, and it has impact on the strength eyes of a student. So great, I mean, solar, then India is the one country where we had the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy started long ago in 1980s. And we are running solar lamp programs from almost 35 years now. And not only India, it is running all over the world. So what is the problem? Why every kerosene lamp is not yet replaced by the solar lamp? And if you look at the statistics, there are, in 2014-15, the amount of kerosene that was consumed in India is almost 10 billion liters, you know, costing 27,000 crore rupees as a subsidy. In that 27,000 crore, actually, you can give 4 solar lamps to every household in the country. So what is the problem? Why it is not, why it is not every kerosene lamp is not replaced? So is the solar module is a problem? Solar module is basically a device which converts sunlight into electricity. Is that a problem? Answer is no, because we are actually talking about National Solar Mission. The world has really progressed a lot. The cost of solar module used to be $100 per watt, you know, about 30 years ago, which has come down to as little as $0.4, $0.5 per watt. Is the circuit problem? The solar lamp requires a circuit. Is circuit is a problem? Answer is no, it is not a problem, because circuit is there everywhere. I mean, every electronic device is having some or other kind of circuit. Is the battery problem? You know, answer is again no, because you know, you have almost every device all around us, you know, uses battery. The laptop uses battery, the mobile phone uses the battery, the remote control use battery. So many ways the batteries are using, and it should not be a problem. And is eventually the body which holds the lamp together, is that a problem? Can't we make a lamp in a manner that, you know, we can actually make solar lamp in a big way? And again, answer is no, because what body requires is just a plastic molding, and there's a plastic all around us. So why this problem is not getting solved, and this is what the whole idea come in picture, and I coming from the village, and I have been always thinking that I am a professor of solar energy in IIT, and doing a research at the technology level doesn't actually bring the solution to the society immediately in the near future. So what can we do it? And the solar lamp programs are, as I said, running from the country for a long time. And I myself was involved in the solar lamp program as early as in 2008-09, where we actually provided 500 solar lamp to as many villages. But after 5-6 months, we do not know what is happening with the lamp. Even if you know that there is something wrong with the lamp, there's nobody to repair it, there's nobody to maintain it. So it did not succeed. Then in 2011-12, I got involved in another program where we kind of, three villages were adopted and we installed solar lamps on a rental model basis. Again, it worked for 4 or 5 months, 6 months, 8 months. You know, a lot of interesting things happened, and then again it dies down. And that is where the question started coming, that what it would take to ensure that the solar lamp program is a sustainable program. So during 2012, when I was on a sabbatical leave for a year, I spent about 3 months in village. Basically, I spent 3 months in an organization called Education Park in Madhya Pradesh. And we started thinking about what should we do it, what can be done it. So we have come across three concepts of doing solar lamp program. One is, we call it a localization. Because solar lamp is not a rocket science. It's a very, very simple device. There are just 10 components associated with it. If you can identify those components, if somebody can learn how to identify and then put them together, then it's easy to do it. So it's not a rocket science and anybody can do it. And definitely villagers can do it. So localization is the one concept. Then we said saturation, that you know, the eventually you need to actually get the benefit of economy of scale. And the benefit of economy of scale comes if you actually do the things in large scale. And our idea of saturation is, can we take a block as a unit where there are 40 villages, 50 villages, 100 villages, and make sure that the solar lamp reaches to all of them? So we started working using this as a saturation. And third, because we are talking about light for study purpose, you know, we have given right to education, but the poor child in the absence of light cannot even execute the right. So we need to give them as a right, and therefore can we make the whole thing affordable by you know, subsidizing it? And this is what we call as a solar urja lamp program. And secondly, we need to do things at a very high speed. We need to do things at a very high scale. And we need to do things at local scale. Why we need to do things at a very high speed? Because somebody has already mentioned that the number of students that drops out of the school is very high. You know, if you look at the statistics of 13-14, if you look at the primary education, there are about 105-110 million students in the school. But if you look at higher secondary enrollment, it comes about 15-20 million only. So many students get dropped. So if you actually do a solar lamp program and which takes 5 years, then we always call it, even the 5 years program will be a failure, because within the 5 years, many students who are in the school will actually get dropped out of school. Then you need to do things at scale, because the country is very, very large, and we need to actually use the local skill. So when I started doing this program and at IIT Bombay, and I actually presented to the officers, and he said, look, you know, you are a professor. You know, why are you doing 1 million program? Why don't you do 10,000 lamp program? You know, just create a model and then somebody else will actually adopt it. And why we are doing 1 million program? Because our idea is not to create just a model. And I really feel that the solar lamp programs are running in the country from last 35 years. And we should really be tired of doing solar lamp program, isn't it? How long we can do solar lamp, solar lamp, solar lamp? You see everywhere there are, you know, central government doing solar lamp program, state government doing solar lamp program, Tendulkar donating solar lamps, and Ambani donating solar lamp, and it keeps happening. We should stop sometime, you know, we should get really tired of sometime. So therefore, we wanted to create a model and show it at the scale, which can be adopted by the country, and do the entire solar lamp program for the in a very, very big scale. And that's why we chose the target to be 1 million lamps to be given in just 1 year time. So the way we do it is, of course, localization. So every operation is to be done by local community. So we train them. And there are many men and many women. We train them. Many of them have actually first time handle any electronic devices. You know, imagine the solar lamp coming in their hand, a solar panel coming in their hand, the electric circuit is coming in their hand. But we actually train them how to use it, you know, how to check whether it's working or not. So they'll be using the multimeters. These are the solar panels. these are the soldering irons. And there is a multimeter sitting here. So all this, they actually get a training. You know how much time it takes to train them to actually make a solar lamp? Just 4 days. And I always believe that the people in village are much more smarter. Sorry to say this in this gathering. The people in the village are much more smarter than people in urban area, because they have to actually deal with the problem. And they have to do things by hand many times, not by just switching a button on and off. And they are quite smart to pick it up. And within 4 days, actually, we give them training. Once we give them training and we provide them raw material, then actually they start assembling the solar lamp. And you can see this is kind of a mini production line sitting in some rural area where each of these men and women actually assembles about 40 lamps a day. They can do more also, but you know, we want to ensure that the quality is in control and people are not making mistakes. So we decided that 40 lamps they can make in a day, and of course they get paid for it. They can earn about 400 rupees a day for making a lamp, and then they get all the component. They test the component in sunlight, and once they do the testing of the component, they put it together, make a solar lamp, put it in a box, and then the lamp is ready for the sale. One of our concept is do not give it for free. If you want a value of your product, do not give it for free. However, ensure that it is subsidized to a level that everybody can afford in the country. And we decided that under the NREGA scheme of daily wages, whatever is the money that one person gets, a one day of wage, that much money anybody can afford in the whole country. And when we started this program, that time the daily wage was 120 rupees. So we said 120 rupees is the price that we are going to sell it, because then it becomes affordable by everyone across the country. So once they make it, then the lamp goes for the distribution. Now when it goes for distribution, it is not given free, so somebody has to sell it. You have to make a sales pitch for it, you know, and some you have to tell the benefit, what is the benefit of solar lamp versus the kerosene lamp, what is the payback period. In fact, though the people may be illiterate, but they understand that in the kerosene, they're every day, month spending about 60 rupees to fetch the kerosene, even at subsidized rate, and the lamp at 120 rupees, is the payback period is 2 months. And I believe everybody can understand in the village, and they're willing to buy it. So this student gets a lamp in their hands in the school. And that is what we wanted to, right? We wanted the lamp to be used for the study purpose and then the study sometime. So when we give the lamp for the study purpose, what happens to the lamp is anything and everything that is possible, right from the delivery of babies to the funeral. And let me share an example. Then there was a case when in some tribal belt, you know, hilly area, the way the delivery happens is, and because it's hilly area, there's no roads, is they put the pregnant women on the bed, and two people actually tie on the bamboo and they walk a couple of kilometers to come to the main road. So there was a case which was the dark night. Somehow they brought the women to the main road, and they're supposed to get an ambulance, but they did not get an ambulance. So they found a four-wheeler, you know, the Mahindra Jeep kind of old. You know, you can imagine the picture, you know, rusty Mahindra Jeep. So the driver said, I cannot drive you. It's the middle of the night. It's a dark night. I cannot drive you because this is a hilly area. There's no headlight in my vehicle. So I can't drive you. So fortunately, in that village, our solar lamp program was conducted. So people quickly went, brought 4 or 5 solar lamp, tied in front of the Jeep. And they drew this woman. They drew this woman about 18 kilometers to bring to the hospital for delivery. As I said, that the lamp is supposed to be meant for study purpose. The kind of things it does to the community is amazing. You know, it actually does everything. In another case, I actually, we sent our IIT student to actually do the study of the lamp, what is happening. And I told my driver, which was in a village, that, you know, you please take this student to the village. And if you find any lamp which is not working, you know, ensure that it gets repaired. And then I told and forgot. And after 15 days, I asked this driver, you know, what happened to this student? And they came. He said, yeah, I took the, main unko leke gaya tha. So then I said, what happened? You, everything is okay? He said, yeah, everything is okay. But in one village, we found a lamp which was not working. I said, what happened to the lamp? He said, the wire came out. Now, have you repaired? He said, there was no electricity in the village. Then the obvious thing that you expect is, you know, repairing doesn't happen because the wire came out, it needs to be soldered. But he said, nahi, par humne usko repair kar diya. I said, well, I mean, I ask any student in Somaya, how can you do the soldering without electricity? The answer will be, no, you can't do it. You know what this guy did? So he took a nail, and there is a kerosene lamp. He put a nail in the kerosene lamp for 5 minutes. So if you put 5 minutes, it becomes red hot. As soon as it becomes red hot, you put near the solder wire, where the temperature requirement is 120 degree, and it gets soldered. You don't need electricity. So when you give the technology in the hands of village, you know, a lot of things it can do. It's amazing things it can do. So our solar lamp utilized in the market, it is utilized for the kitchen, it is utilized for the milking the cows, it is utilized for the going to the toilet, it is utilized going to the field. And we did this program already completed, so we reached to 1 million student. We reached 1 million student and we covered 65,000 square kilometer area. Now being an academic institution, it was a big task to reach to 1 million covering 65,000 square kilometer area, covering more than 10,900 villages. We trained about 1,400 people, and we opened what you call the Soul Repair Center. Now, by this is Solar Urja Lamp Repair Center. And jokingly, we also say, if any soul's in trouble, you can bring to this repair centers, and we can repair it. So this is a scale. And if you can get the more details on the website, there's another interesting image I would like to share, that the many teachers, you know, they have wrote to us, and that, you know, how the students actually cannot anymore make any about the homework. They cannot say about the homework. So what happens, that every, because the lamp is there, they have to do the homework. They cannot make any excuses anymore. So this teacher, on the day of 15th August, he wanted to send us this picture. You know, so typically 15th August is celebrated in the morning, right? So he actually was so wanted to do it that he asked student to stay there in the school till the evening. And if you notice that, there is a solar lamp sitting with each of the student. So as soon as the sun set, this happens. So that is what we need to do. So we need to give the light. We need to give the light to every student, not only in the country, but across the world. So what we would like to bring this message, that we have already done 1 million. And looking at this program, we already proposed to the government mission for the whole nation. And the government has already sponsored a 7 million lamp program. So right now, we are working to provide 7 million lamp in UP, Bihar, Assam, Jharkhand, and Odisha. But if you look at the whole country, there are about 220 million people who are using kerosene as a main source of lighting. And if you look across the world, there are 1,200 million people who are using kerosene as a main source of lighting. So in the time when we are sending our mission to Mars, in the time when you're talking about 3G technology and 4G technology, in the time when we are talking about LED screens, we are talking about the smartphones, I think what we need to do is to assure them a right to clean light also. Thank you very much.